हेलो वेलकम फ्रेंड्स टू ऑल ऑफ यू इन दिस ऑनलाइन सेशन। इन द प्रीवियस सेशन सिमिलैरिटी पार्ट टू वी हैव डिस्कस्ड विद बेसिक प्रोपोर्शनैलिटी थ्योरम दैट इज BPT एंड कॉन्वर्स ऑफ बेसिक प्रोपोर्शनैलिटी थ्योरम CBPT वेर इन वी कंसिडर दिस फिगर। In triangle ABC, if line L is parallel to side BC and line L intersects AB and AC in point P and Q respectively, then AP upon PB is equal to AQ upon QC and vice versa. Means the converse of this BPT also discussed. Problems based on these theorems also we have been saw. So today we will continue with application of this basic proportionality theorem. So the first application of this basic proportionality theorem is property of an angle bisector of a triangle. What is the statement of this one? The bisector of an angle of a triangle divides the side opposite to the angle in the ratio of the remaining sides. For this, let us consider this figure wherein the brown color segments indicates the constructive part. So from this figure and the statement, we can write the given in triangle ABC. Bisector of angle C intersects segment AB in the point E. So to prove will be AE upon AB is equal to CA upon CB. For that construction is draw line parallel to ray CE passing through the point B. Extend AC so as to intersect it at point D and ACD is the betweenness. Let us prove this property. Ray CE is parallel to ray BD and AD is the transversal. Therefore, angle ACE is equal to angle CDB by the corresponding angle property. Let it be statement number 1. Now, ray CE is parallel to ray BD and BC is the transversal. At that time, angle ECB is equal to angle CBD by alternate angles property. This be the statement number 2. But angle AC is congruent with angle ECB. It is a given statement number 3. In triangle CBD, side CB is congruent with side CD. That sides opposite to congruent angles. Therefore, CB is equal to CD. It is the statement 4. Now, in triangle ABD, segment EC is parallel to segment BD. That we construction did. Therefore, AE upon AB is equal to CA upon CD by using basic proportionality theorem statement number 5. Here, in this statement number 5, to the right hand side, CD is equal to CB, which is in statement number 4. We can replace that and we will get that AE upon AB is equal to CA upon CB. This is what the angle bisector theorem. Now, let us discuss one problem based on this property. So, in triangle ABC, segment BD bisects angle ABC, AB is equal to X, BC is equal to X plus Y, AD is X minus 2, DC is X plus 2, then we have to find out the value of X, means the segment's value is given in terms of X. So, let us try for this one. In triangle ABC, segment BD bisects angle ABC, BD with color shown with red color is the bisector of angle B. Therefore, by the theorem of an angle bisector of a triangle, we can write AB upon BC is equal to AD upon DC. Now, we'll substitute the values. We'll get X divided by X plus 5 is equal to X minus 2 divided by X plus 2. We can now cross multiply. Therefore, X into X plus 2 is equal to X minus 2 in one bracket, X plus 5 in another bracket. So, to the left hand side, we'll solve the bracket. X square plus 2X will be equal to, from the first bracket X, we have to multiply to the whole second bracket X plus 5 minus 2 from the first bracket. We'll again multiply to the whole X plus 5 bracket. So the next simplification will be X square plus 2X as it is from the left hand side will be equal to, we'll multiply X square plus 5X minus 2X minus 10. Therefore, X square get cancelled. What left is 2x is equal to 3x minus 10. Here 3x will come to the left hand side. So 2x minus 3x is equal to minus 10. the subtraction to the left hand side leads to minus x, which will be minus 10. Therefore, these two signs gets cancelled, so we will get x is equal to 10, which is the required value of x. Now, let us see the second application of this BPT, that is the converse of angle bisector theorem. The statement is like this: if a point is in the interior of an angle and equidistant from the sides, then it lies on the bisector of that angle. This is the figure where brown color indicates the constructive part. Given that from figure and the statement, in triangle ABC, AD divides BC in the ratio of the sides continuing the angles A to meet BC at D. That is, AB upon AC is equal to BD upon DC. So what you have to prove? This AD is the bisector of angle A, you have to prove. For that, we have to do the construction. Draw CE parallel to DA to meet BA produced at E such that BAE is the betweenness. So let us carry the proof. In triangle ABC, CE is parallel to DA and AE is the transversal. So we will get angle BAD is equal to angle AEC by corresponding angle property, statement 1. Also, CE is parallel to DA and AC is the transversal. Here we will be getting angle DAC is equal to angle ACE by alternate angles property. Second statement, in triangle BEC, CE is parallel to AD. Therefore, AB upon AE is equal to BD upon DC by using basic proportionality theorem, statement 3. But it is given that AB upon AC is equal to BD upon DC, statement number 4. So we get AB upon AE is equal to AB upon AC from 3 and 4. Therefore, AB at the numerator on both sides is same. Therefore, we can write AE is equal to AC. Therefore, angle AEC is equal to angle ACE, isosceles triangle property, or you can write angle opposite to the congruent side, statement number 5. According to the equation 1, 2 and 5, you will get angle BAD is congruent with angle DAC. As BAD is congruent DAC, we can say that AD is bisecting angle A. This is what the converse of the angle bisector theorem. Now we'll see one of the problem based on this property. Observe the adjoining figure and identify whether ray PM is the bisector of angle QPR. So we have to identify this one. Let us start from the figure. In triangle PQR, PQ is 9, PR is 10, QM is 3.6 and MR is 6, given thing from the figure. So now PQ upon PR is equal to 9 upon 10. As given PQ 9 and PR 10, we will getting this ratio, statement number 1. Also, this QM upon MR, which will be equal to 3.6 upon 4, decimal point, we'll convert this into integer by multiplying 10 to the numerator and denominator. So we'll get 36 upon 40, which is equal to 9 upon 10. This is statement number 2. So in triangle this PQR, from 1 and 2, what you are getting? 9 upon 10, 9 upon 10. Right hand side is same. Therefore, you can write PQ upon PR is equal to QM upon MR. So in triangle PQR, we are getting PQ upon PR is equal to QM upon MR. Therefore, by the converse of the angle bisector theorem of a triangle, we can write ray PM is the bisector of angle P, or you may say angle QPR. This is what one problem based on that. Now let us see the third application of BPT. Property of three parallel lines and their transversal. The statement is, the ratio of the intercepts made on the transversal by three parallel lines is equal to the ratio of the corresponding intercepts made on any other transversals by the same parallel lines. This could be the figure. Line L, line M, line N, these are the parallel lines, and T1 and T2 are the transversals. So we can write the given like this: line L parallel to line M, parallel to line N, and T1 and T2 are the transversals. Transversal T1 intersects the lines in points A, B, C, and T2 intersects the lines in point P, Q, R respectively. Here we have to show that AB upon BC is equal to PQ upon QR, See, we'll do the proof. Draw segment PC which intersects line M at point D. You can construct PC or you can construct AR, doesn't matter. In triangle ACP, shown with blue color triangle, BD is parallel to AP. Therefore, we can use the BPT. So you are getting AB upon BC is equal to BD upon DC, statement 1. Also in triangle CPR, which is shown with pink color, this DQB is parallel to CR. Therefore, by using BPT, you are getting PD upon DC is equal to PQ upon QR, statement number 2. From 1 and 2, you could observe that the value of PD upon DC from statement 2 can be kept in 1. So you are getting AB upon BC is equal to PQ upon QR, means AB upon BC is equal to PQ upon QR, which is your requirement that you are going to prove. This is the three parallel lines and the transversal property. Let us see one problem based on this. In the trapezium ABCD, side AB parallel to side PQ is parallel to side DC. AB is 15, PD is 12, QC is 14, you have to find out the value of BQ. So, we'll try. In trapezium ABCD, side AB parallel to side PQ parallel to side DC. Therefore, by using the property of three parallel lines and their transversal, we can write AP upon PD is equal to BQ upon QC. We substitute the values. Therefore, we are getting 15 upon 12 is equal to BQ upon QC. Therefore, by cross multiplication, BQ into 12 is equal to 15 into 14. Therefore, BQ will be equal to 15 into 14 divided by 12. Again, simplification, BQ is equal to 5 into 14 upon 4, which will be equal to 5 into 7 divided by 2, which is 7 into 5. 35 divided by 2, you will be getting 17.5. That is, the BQ value is 17.5. Friends, till now, what we have been discussed in this session? Just to recap, first thing, property of an angle bisector of a triangle, contours of angle bisector theorem, then property of three parallel lines and their transversal. These three applications of PPT we have been discussed. At the same time, we have been discussed one problem based on the above theorems. This topic is very easy, prepare well. So, one thing you have to keep it in mind. Before that, you have to try these two problems that has been given. In triangle PQR, segment ST is parallel to side QR. Segment ST divides triangle PQR into two equal parts in area, and you have to determine QS upon PQ. So, one more problem. In the adjoining figure, ray PT is the bisector of angle QPR. Find the value of X and perimeter of triangle PQR. So, you should have to keep in mind that mathematics is not about numbers, equation, computations or algorithms. It is about understanding. A sentence by William Paul Thurston. So, please subscribe, share and like this video. With these words, thank you everyone.